In this video, we're going to answer the question I get all the time. What the heck is Bakelite and why is it so expensive? Invented by Leo Baekeland, a Belgian chemist, in 1907. It's a phenolic formaldehyde resin, which basically means it's a fancy plastic that during the process of making it, the odors are harmful to you. It was initially developed because it's very strong but doesn't conduct heat. You'll find everything made out of Bakelite, from telephones, radios, doorknobs, and some fantastic jewelry. But how do you know if it's Bakelite or just some other plastic? One of the things that you can do is rub it with your fingers or put it under hot water, and yes, smell it. If it smells like formaldehyde or has a really strong odor, it's Bakelite. Also, Bakelite won't have a seam inside of it. It's not poured like a plastic, it's molded. The colors do change over time, so don't be surprised if you see varying forms of it. Even the old ones have changed color over time because of the chemical composition. A lot of the clear ones are now brownish or like a tortoise color. Another chemical test that you can do is get simichrome. It's a popular metal polish. Put the polish on a piece of paper towel. Rub it onto the bracelet or piece of jewelry. If you then look at your paper towel, it's going to have a yellowish mark if the test is positive for Bakelite. If you do it and no color comes up, just the color of the polish, it's not pure Bakelite. This piece that has a bunch of different colors swirled together is referred to as end of the day Bakelite, meaning at the end of the day, they would take whatever was left in the vats, mix it all together, and this is what you would come up with. Some people prefer it, some people hate it, just buy what you love. There's lots more to learn about Bakelite, so don't forget to check back for more videos and information on our website and Facebook page, Malena's Vintage Boutique.